वक्रतुण्डमखाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषजे भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम्। साक्षात् कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Today is 28th class. You can repeat. Vasudevendra Yogindram.
Vasudevendra Yogindram.
Natva Jnanapradam Gurum.
Natva Jnanapradam Gurum.
मुक्षूणां हितार्थाय तत्त्वबोधोऽभिधीयते साधनचतुष्टय सम्पन्नाधिकारिणां मोक्षसाधनभूतम् तत्त्वविवेकप्रकारं वक्ष्यामः साधनचतुष्टयं किम् नित्यानित्यवस्तुविवेकः इहामुत्रार्थफलभोगविरागः समाधिषट्कसम्पत्तिः मुमुक्षुत्वं चेति नित्यानित्यवस्तुविवेकः कः नित्यवस्तु एकं ब्रह्म तद्व्यतिरिक्तं सर्वम् अनित्यम्
अनित्यम्
अयमेव नित्या नित्यवस्तु विवेकः यः स्वर्गभोगेषु इच्छाराहित्यम् समाधिषट्कसम्पत्तिः का शमः दमः उपरमः तितिक्षा श्रद्धा समाधानं च इति शमः कः चक्षुरादिन्द्रिय निग्रहः परमः कः धर्मानुष्ठानम् एव शीतोष्ण सुख दुःखादि सहिष्णुत्वम् श्रद्धा कीदृशी गुरुवेदान्तवाक्येषु विश्वासः श्रद्धा समाधानं किम् चित्तैकाग्रता क्षोमे भूयात् इति इच्छा एतत् साधनचतुष्टयम् ततः तत्त्वविवेकस्य अधिकारिणः भवन्ति In the last class, we have seen, we have discussed in detail, last few classes, Viveka. Viveka is Nitya Anitya Vastu, Viveka. Which is the first and the foremost, the qualification expected from the student of Vedanta. The consequence of Viveka is the next one, which is Viraga, otherwise called Vairagyam. This is the second in the list of Sadhana Chatushtayam, the fourfold disciplines. You can call it as qualification, Sadhanam, or disciplines. Sadhanani, Jnana Sadhanani, Sadhana Chatushtaya means for getting a yogyata for the pursuit of jnanam, moksha. That is why it is called Sadhana Chatushtayam. Jnana Sadhanani, Jnanaya Sadhanam. And the second in the list is Vairagyam, otherwise called viraga. Raga, the word, to the word raga, the upasarga V is added. Upasarga means prefix. In Sanskrita Vyakaranam, upasarga means prefix, added before. Pratyaya added after. Pratyaya means suffix. The whole language is nothing but the prakriti plus pratyayas. And the upasarga. Upasarga, adding that to a word. Either it can intensify the meaning of the word, or it can retain the same meaning, or it can modify the meaning, or it sometimes can give quite opposite meaning. These four things a upasarga can do. And here the upasarga, the prefix B, gives the opposite meaning. Raga means attachment. Raga means attachment, passion, translated as passion. Viraga, dispassion, absence of passion, freedom from passion. Viraga. Like we have the word smriti. Smriti means memory. Smarati, vismarati, forgets. Opposite of smaranam, vismaranam, forgetfulness, vismaranam. Adding V gives the opposite meaning. Smarati, vismarati. Dega, body. Absence of body, videga. Dega, videga. Similarly, here also, raga, viraga. Viraga is the second qualification, sadhanam, following viveka, which means dispassion, the second discipline. And what does it say here? Viraga, what is viraga? The student as the teacher, what is viraga? The teacher says, iha swarga bhogeshu iccha ragityam. Iha mutrata palaboga viraga. That is what the teacher said before. Iha amutra, and amutra is defined here. Iha mutrata palabhoga viraga. In the list of sadhana chatushtayam, the teacher said, what is amutra? Amutra is swarga bhoga. Swarga, swarga is amutra. Iha means here. Amutra is swarga. There. Amutra is there. Where? Swarga. So here, as well as in swarga, the place which is reached after death, after this life, bhogeshu iccha rakityam. Bhoga is enjoyment. With regard to the enjoyment of here in this loka as well as in the loka which we reach after this life, with regard to that, iccha rakityam. Iccha is desire. Rahityam, devoid of, free from the desire, free from the longing for the enjoyments of the pleasure of this world as well as the other world. That is called viragaha. That is called viragaha. What are the bhogas in this world? So many enjoyments are there in this world. Power, money, all sorts of pleasures. Everything is available as bhoga vastu. And almost all the people are after this bhoga, either in one form or other form. Running after this bhoga, it's an indication for the lack of vairagya. Vairagya is not there, therefore they run after this. Thinking that these pleasures will make them happy, comfortable, and they want this in more and more in life. Invariably, if you analyze the pursuit of people, it will be either after this power, pleasure, money, all this towards the bhoga mandi. Either for this, either to enjoy that in this world or in the other world. At least in our Vaidika Sampradaya, people believed that there is a loka, a place called Swarga. A Swarga is a place where you go and you come back. You don't stay there forever. It's a picnic spot. It's a place for recreation. You go, exhaust all your capital, that is punyam, whatever you gained in this world by doing good karma, by reaching out action, whatever you gained, and also by the yajnadi karma, Our Shastram says, if a Vaidika karma doesn't specify any karma pala, for that, the blanket rule is Svarga Loka Prapti. If no karma pala is mentioned for any karma, then the karma pala is Svarga Loka Prapti. So, and there are karma in the Karmakanda part of the Veda to reach Svarga Loka. People were doing all those karma because they were Vaidikas, they believe in the Shastram, and Shastram being the Pramanam, they believe in the Shastram, and therefore they did karma to go to Svarga Loka. They had the desire to go to Svarga Loka and enjoy. It is not a wrong desire. It is fine. It's a dharmika. They want to enjoy pleasure in Svarga, therefore they did that karma. So therefore, going to Svarga Loka is not a wrong desire. People can have any desire. So going to Svarga Loka, and for that doing a karma, it is accepted by the Shruti. There is no problem in that. And since they were all Vaidikas, therefore they believed in Svarga Loka. Shastram says, therefore they believe. But we don't have that problem, because hardly we follow any Vaidika karma, Vaidika lifestyle. But we follow to certain extent. Not literally what the Veda says. We don't do any Vaidika karma also. If at all we do simple Sandhya Vandanam karma, Nitya karma. That is only Nitya karma we do. Or some Naimittika karma, occasional obligatory duties we do. How many people they do Agnihotra or other karma in these days? Very, very, very rare. Few people only. The Vaidika lifestyle consists of doing karma the whole day. Whole day they will be doing karma. So therefore, at least Svarga, we need not bother. We need not bother because nobody works for going to Svarga. They want to have Svarga here. They want to have the Svarga here. Therefore, for us, the important thing is Iga only. Iga Bhogeshu. The enjoyment here in this world only. Svarga is more relevant for the Vaidika people. If at all, if you are a believer of Svarga, then you can take Svarga also. But Svarga is there, it is there, our Shastram says. Therefore, we can accept. It is not a question of not accepting. When we accept Shastra as a Pramanam, then we have to accept Svarga also. Because Shastram says Svarga is there. Therefore, there is no problem in accepting Svarga. If Svarga is not there, if you say, then you have to prove. You have to prove Svarga is not there. How will you prove? You can disprove only. You can disprove something only when you don't see it. You may say Swarga is not seen now, it's not available for perception now, therefore I don't believe. Many things are not available for perception. So do we dismiss? You cannot prove it. You cannot prove by Anumanadi, Pratyaksha Anumanadi Pramana, Swarga cannot be proved. At the same time, you cannot disprove it also. You cannot disprove it also. Going to Swarga after death, it is possible, it is believable. But saying that Swarga is permanent, you will go there and stay there forever, that is illogical. You have to see the logicality in belief also. A belief, as long as a belief is has got a logic, there is no problem. But in illogical belief, that lies a problem. Because many beliefs, they are illogical. Many religions have this illogical, their own illogical beliefs. And when you ask them to prove it, they come for fight. But we don't do that. We say, Swarga is logical. We don't say Swarga is eternal. Swarga is Nitya, we don't say. As this Loka is not Nitya, it is Anitya, so too Swarga Loka is. This loka, this world is a place for the experiences of experiences of the of dukkha and sukha, both. It's a place of experience. This jagat is a place of experience. So to Swarga Loka also. In this jagat, in the world, as long as you live, you undergo certain experiences. Whether good experiences or bad experiences, depending on your karma, papa and punya. It's an experience. Experience come and experience go. They don't stay with you forever. Because every experience has background. Karma is there in the form of papa and punya. Papa and punya, they don't attack you forever. Neither punyam will give you eternal pleasure, nor papam will give you eternal dukkham also. Both being the result of karma, and the karma being limited, they stay with you, or you enjoy them for a limited period of time. Therefore, they are anitya only. So, whatever you enjoy in this world is anitya. The same thing is projected to the other world also. Whether it is Swarga or Naraka. Swarga the place of pleasure, Naraka the place of pain. Can be extended. There also, you go there, you undergo the experiences based on your karma. And karma being limited, when it get exhausted, then you come down. Kshine punye martyalokam vishanti. If the punya, that is your capital, what you gained by doing good karma in this janma, in the world, that you encashed in Swarga Loka, and once the punyas are exhausted, kshine punye, then come back to martyaloka, martyalokam vishanti. This is logical. You go to Swarga Loka and you live forever, we never say that. So this is a logical belief. Swarga Loka is a logical belief. Wanting to enjoy a different sort of pleasures, using different instruments, different bodies. The bodies will not be like this. It's a special body. It's all acceptable. No problem in that. Logical. But what is the focus is the bhoga, an enjoyment, whether here or there. Therefore, bhoga, bhogeshu, it is saptami, vibhakti, bhogeshu, vishaya saptami, with reference to enjoyments. It is translated as with regard to or with reference to the enjoyments. Vishaye, bhoga vishayeshu, bhogeshu, iha swarga, here and hereafter. Iccha ragityam. Iccha ragityam, absence of desire for the pleasures of this world or the other world. And swarga bhoga, regarding swarga bhoga. Swarga Bhoga, even in the Kathopanishad, Kathopanishad, Nachiketa says, Svargaloke nabayam kinchanasti, natatratum narjaraya bibeti, ubetirtva ashanaya pipase shokatigo modate svargaloke. Yamadharma Raja in Kathopanishad, he wanted to somehow distract Nachiketa. He wanted to distract Nachiketa. And therefore he offered a lot of things to Nachiketa. Because he has such a question. What question? He wanted to know whether Atma is there. He has a very important question. And Yamadharma Raja, he wanted to test Nachiketa. Therefore, he was trying to somehow distract Nachiketa. Don't ask for Atma Jnanam. You ask for anything else, I will give you. Because Yamadharma Raja promised three boons to Nachiketa. Because Nachiketa, when he went to Yamaloka, there he had to wait for 3 days and 3 nights because Yamadharma Raja was out on some duty. He didn't turn up for the 3 days. And when he came back, he saw the young Brahmin boy waiting at the entrance for 3 days and 3 nights without having food. So Yamadharma Raja offered him 3 boons for his mistake. And Nachiketa, he encashed the first 2 boons. The last boon in the form of a question, but in the form of the knowledge, what he wanted was, some people say Atma is there. After death, Atma survives. Some people say they don't survive. Some people say there is no Atma. After death, it doesn't survive. I want to know the truth of it. I want to know the truth of it. Is there Atma or not? What happens to the Jiva after Marana? This a question a boy of 9 years he asked Yamadharma Raja. This is a question everybody has from the very beginning, but we don't clarify this with anyone. And even if we are taught, we would not have enough maturity to understand. But this young boy, asked this question to Yamadharma Raja. Yamadharma Raja did not take it seriously. He wanted to convince, cajole, distract Nachiketa from further dwelling on this topic. Therefore, he offered everything. He said, Shatayushav putra potran vrinishva bahun pashun hasti iranyam ashvan bhumer nagadayatanam vrinishva svayam cha jiva sharado yavadichasi etat tulyam idi manyasevaram vrinishva vittam chirajivikam cha mahabhumo nachiketastvam idi kamanantva kamabhajam karomi. Yamadharma Raja says this. You can live in this world, going back to Bhuloka, there you live for 100 years. 100 is only a number, more than 100 years. Satayushaha. With putra and potra, with sons and grandsons. All the pashu stands for wealth, cattle. All the wealth, hasti, hiranyam, gold, ashva, horses, everything. And you ask for the vast portion of the land. You become the king of the land, king of the earth. Or anything equivalent to that you ask, I'll give you. But please don't ask me about this Atma. He was trying to dissuade Nachiketa from asking this question. That is, Yamadharma Raja is testing. Yamadharma Raja tests Nachiketa whether he still has the desire for enjoying the pleasures of the world. Iha bogeshu, whether he has got icha or not, that he is testing, offering all the pleasures of the world. You become the king of the entire Jagat. You will rule over even the president of US. And whatever you want, I will make you the partaker of all the enjoyments. But Nachiketa did not budge even a little. And when he saw the reaction of Nachiketa, he further offered. Now he tempts him with the pleasures of the Swarga Loka. Ye ye kamaha durlabha martya loke sarvan kamagus chandatav prarthayasva ima ramaha sarataha satūryaha nahi drisha lambaniya manushyehi abhirmatta vifparicharayasva achiketo maranam manuprakshihi ima ramaha sarataha satūryaha. All these beautiful damsels, angels of the Swarga Loka, and all the special vehicles, ratas, along with the horses, along with the horses, and all the pleasures which are difficult to gain in the Martya Loka, which are available in the Swarga Loka, other Loka, you ask for that, and I will give you everything, all the music parties, Ima Ramaha Sarataha, all the beautiful angels, damsels, Amramba, Urvashi, all the, along with their instruments of music, vehicles, everything I will give you. All the Vimana, special vehicle, Pushpaka Vimana, Airavata, you ask, everything will be given. These are the things available in the Swarga Loka. The Swarga Loka, Kalpaka Vriksha is there, Kamadenu is there, Kalpaka Vriksha, Vishpulin tree, Kamadenu. Asking whatever you want, you ask, it will give. Just imagine that will just appear before you. And in Swarga Loka, you don't grow old, you don't have anger, you don't have thirst also. There is no thirst, there is no growing old. You be the same person throughout. You be the same person. No anger, nothing is there. So you be the same person all the time. Everything I will give you, whatever you enjoy in Swarga Loka, that I will give you. So now, Yamadharma Raja tempting Nachiketa with the pleasures of the Swarga Loka. But Nachiketa did not budge. He was very so firm that he wanted only that. He was so very firm on that. That shows its vairagya. Even though anybody in his place, definitely, if he is given the long life and all the pleasures which are unimaginable, even for a manishya to enjoy in Martya Loka, Swarga Loka pleasures, unimaginable. A person gets, he may go for it, but Nachiketa did not budge. That shows his vairagya. That is why iha swarga bhogeshu icharagetyam. If the person has that much vairagya, the commitment to what he needs, that commitment, that attitude is important for the student of Vedanta. So therefore, this Swarga Loka is a very big thing. At least for the people who are the followers of this Vaidika karma, for them, at least in those days, it was a big thing. And descriptions of Swarga Loka is like that. You enjoy very subtle pleasures and long-lasting pleasures. You don't grow old. So all these things, that is what we expect here in this Bhuloka, which is not possible. Therefore, Swarga Loka is the best option. Even with regard to that, the desire should not be there. If it is so, then what to talk about the desire with regard to in this world, with regard to the the enjoyments of this world. Therefore, Ichcha, complete Ichcha Ragityam. Ichcha means desire, longing. Ragityam, absence. Complete absence of longing for the bogas. For the bogas. Why it is said? Is the Shastra disencourage, doesn't want you to pursue this, all this boga? If you are a person in the beginning stage of life, following the Karmakanda portion of the Veda, doing all the activities, then you go for it. Shastra allows that. Because you are yet, you are not fit for it, or you are not come to Vedanta. So you want Dharma Artha Kama, please go ahead. Even though it is anitya, but that is not the time to teach the person. These are anitya. As long as a person follows dharma and pursues his desire in keeping with dharma, there is no problem. Shastra encourages the person. Human beings only have the privilege of entertaining the desire and go after it. Therefore, Shastra encourages us. At that time, we should not say it is anitya. This will not be everlasting. That is not the time for the Upadesha. Because the student did not ask for that. When he is not asking, then advice should not be given. Na aprishtaha kasyachit bruyat. Don't teach when it is not asked. Now, because we come to study Vedanta, therefore, here it has to be taught. The limitation of the vastus, limitations of the experiences which the vastu can give, that has to be taught. They are anitya. It will not give nitya sukham, and it will not give the complete satisfaction also. Atripti will be there. With regard to the pleasures in this world, at least it is anitya and atripti, and dukkha also mixed up. Dukkha mishritattvam is there. Maybe in Svargaloka it is not there. Svargaloka it is also anityam. It is anityam because the pleasure, the bhoga, stays there for certain period of time. And maybe some amount of satisfaction may be there. But as long as it is limited in terms of time, even the tripti will not be there. Once that is over, that anchoring for that will not subside. Will continue to be. And there is no mix-up with dukkha. That is the only positive thing in Svarga Loka. Even with regard to that, the person doesn't have desire, doesn't have passion. That state of mind of a discerning person, the Viveki, is called Ichcha Ragityam. It's called Ichcha Ragityam. Therefore, Iha Svarga Bogeshu Ichcha Ragityam. And this Ichcha Ragityam, that is Vairagyam, as we said, it is a natural consequence of Viveka. Vivekaha Asti Chet Vairagyaha Viraha Bhavati. Why? Because a Viveka is with regard to your choice. Options are there and you have the free will to choose. A choice is always depend on your Viveka, your discrimination. Choice is always dependent on Viveka. You have got a choice, Nitya and Anitya. Unless you have Viveka, if you don't have Viveka, you will go for Anitya. If you have Viveka, you will go for Nitya. You will go for Nitya. Therefore, Vairagyam is a natural consequence of Viveka. I am interested in Nitya Sukham. And Nitya Vastu is Brahma. Therefore, Brahma Jnanam alone will make me a complete person. Will alone will make, remove the wanting I, The I is always wanting. The I is always not happy. The I is always not pleased, dissatisfied. This Nitya Vastu alone will knock off that dissatisfied I, unhappy I. Therefore, if you want that, then there is no choice. You have to choose Brahma Vidya. There is no choice other than Brahma Vidya if you want Nitya Sukham, Nitya Vastu. Nitya Vastu alone can give you Nitya Sukham. Nitya Sukham means you are at yourself. Come to know that Aham Purnaha. Nothing can fill me up. Nothing can fill me up. Thinking that something will fill me up, that is Aviveka. That is Aviveka. Aviveka is there, Vairagya will not come. Viveka is there, Vairagya will come. Therefore, lack of discrimination, that is Aviveka, is a cause for lack of Vairagya. If Viveka is there, then you don't have to ask for Vairagya. Vairagyam will be natural. Therefore, Vairagyam towards a thing which is not desirable, based on the knowledge that it is not desirable. That is Vairagyam. Therefore, Vairagyam is important, which is the second qualification. And we have discussed, Vairagyam is not hatred. Vairagyam is not hatred or disgust for things or beings in the world. It is not something you give up physically. That is not Vairagyam. Things may be around you, very close, but still you are not carried over by it. That is Vairagyam. You will not be carried over by the Bhogavastu because you know the limitation of the Bhogavastu. You don't add any subjective values to the Bhogavastu. All the objects being limited, they can give you only limited sukham, limited pleasure, limited comfort, everything limited. So you will not add any subjective value to it. You will give the value as it deserves. You will be very objective towards that. So therefore, Vairagyam is not hatred. It's not neither hatred nor just giving up physically. Physical giving up is not Vairagyam. Similarly, Vairagyam is not because that something undesirable things happen in your life. That is also not Vairagyam. Sukham comes, Dukkham also comes. Sukham and Dukkham, they are part and parcel of the life. Because something undesirable happened, therefore I got disgusted, I got total dispassion. No, that is not the Vairagyam. That is Smashana Vairagyam. That lasts only for a few days. After that, it will dry up. It is Anitya Vairagyam. Therefore, Vairagyam, for Vairagya, the means is Viveka. Vairagya, for getting Vairagya, the sadhanam is Viveka. And for Viveka, the sadhanam is Karma Yoga. Karma Yogena Vivekaha and Vivekat Vivekena Viragaha. So therefore, now if you ask, if Vairagya is the natural consequence of Viveka, then Viveka alone can be mentioned. We need not mention Vairagya. Why should we mention Vairagya separately? Because Viveka is there, therefore Vairagya must be there. It's a natural thing. For that we say, if a person has Nitya Nishtya Vastu Viveka, there will be Vairagya. Nitya Nitya Vastu Viveka is there, Vairagya will be there. But it is not, need not be there in all the cases. Because of our samskara, our orientation, still we can go for bhoga. Even though we know it is not good, still we can go for bhoga. That is because of habitual value. That is the value what we have picked up over a period of time. And therefore, there is a raga for it. therefore we go after it. That is why even though after Viveka there should be Vairagya, one has to continuously put effort to develop Vairagya by seeing the dosha, in the Vishaya. I know very well, I have got Viveka to understand, to see the things, to the defects in the things, but still I go after it because of my samskara. Even though I know it is filled with defects. The Vishayas, the Bhoga Vishayas are with defects. Doshas are there, even though I know. But because of my samskara, my old habits, I go after it. So therefore, Vairagyam should be mentioned separately. That is why it is mentioned. And also Anitya Vastu Nishchaya. That is discerning that Anitya Vastu alone will not give Vairagyam also. Knowing the Anitya Vastu alone will not give Vairagyam. Knowing Anitya Vastu is one thing. Anitya Vastu will not free me, will not make me free. That is one thing. But the dispassion must be there towards that. If dispassion is not there, Anitya Vastu will not free me, will be that knowledge will be there, but still you may go after it. Anitya Vastu will not make me free, but the dispassion towards may be there, may not be there. And we may be continue to be a seeker of the Anitya Vastu. Possible. Therefore, Anitya Vastu Nishchaya alone cannot give Vairagyam. Even though we know it is Nitya, but we don't have anything better. Therefore, we go after it. There are situations like that. Therefore, one has to know that there is a Nitya Vastu. Anitya Vastu Nishchaya and Nitya Vastu Nishchaya. One has to know the Nitya Vastu also. That is why Viveka. Nitya Vastu Nishchaya, that comes only from the Shastram. Nitya Vastu can only give Nitya Sukham, total satisfaction. Therefore, Anitya Vastu Nishchaya, refraining from Anitya Vastu and going after Nitya Vastu. Two things are there. And therefore, Viveka, and out of Viveka, now Vairagya is born. Therefore, you withdraw from Anitya Vastu and go after Nitya Vastu. Nitya Vastu being Brahma. Therefore, the pursuit is Brahma. And Brahma is gained by the study of Shastram. Shastra Jnanena. Study is involved. Therefore, Vedanta. Vedanta study of Shastram. And this Vairagya, its importance. What is the importance of Vairagya? If you ask, Vairagyam gives the commitment for the pursuit of moksha. Moksha is of the goal. Freedom is the goal. And for that, commitment is required. And Vairagyam gives that commitment. If Vairagyam is there, it will make us relatively free from any problem. You don't get stuck up with any person or any object or any situation or any comfort. If Vairagyam is there, it will make you relatively free. And if Vairagyam is there, you will have less conflict with things. Because the desires what you have, it will not be a binding desire. It will be a non-binding desire. Desires may be there still, but as long as it is not binding, no problem. Only if it is a binding desire, it's a problem. And if it is a adharmika binding desire, it's all the more problem. If it is a dharmika non-binding desire, no problem. So therefore, if it is a non-binding desire, then there is no problem and no conflict. And non-binding desire implies the presence of vairagyam. Certain objectivity is there. If I gain that, it is fine. If I don't gain that also, it is fine. No problem. It is not going to make a big dent on me. That is the sign of vairagyam. And that gives us inner strength. It gives us inner strength and it relatively makes me free from helplessness. In fact, it is a shorter, abridged version of moksha, if at all we can say. It is an abridged version of moksha. So moksha, the vairagyam gives relative freedom. You are not dependent on anything for your comfort, for your happiness. Because you have set in objectivity towards the things, therefore, you don't depend on anything. It depend on any object, depend on any people for your comfort, for your pleasure, for your freedom. You give one the place what it deserves, neither more nor less. That objectivity gives me the freedom to be with myself. And ultimate thing is moksha. That is what is ultimate freedom is with myself. But vairagyam gives us in a relative measure. That's why I said it's an abridged version of moksha. And vairagyam gives us the strength to face life situations. It gives strength to follow the values which are the sadhanam required to prepare for moksha. So vairagyam is very important. If vairagyam is there, then the next qualifications, shamadi shatka sampattihi, which are listed out, these can be gained. Therefore, vairagyam is important. And we have seen viveka as a means for vairagyam. When viveka is practiced properly, then naturally it will lead to vairagyam. And for viveka, karma yoga. Therefore, karma yoga also indirectly helps to gain vairagyam. Doing action with proper attitude and whatever comes as a result, taking that as Ishvara prasada, that attitude is important. If attitude is there, then naturally vairagyam will be there. When that attitude is there, then you don't have raga or dvesha. You don't have raga and dvesha towards the action and towards the result of the action also. Raga and dvesha. Raga is attachment, dvesha is aversion. You don't have towards the action. And the action is your dharma, what you are supposed to do. If you have raga towards what you are supposed to do, then there is no problem. As long as you are willing to do, you like what you do, what you are supposed to do, then there is no problem. But if you don't like to do what you are supposed to do, then there is a problem. If you don't like to do what you are supposed to do, you are not willing to do your dharma, you have got certain dvesha is there, then what will you do? You will do what you are not supposed to do. You will do adharma. That is rubbing with the order of Ishvara. That is rubbing with the order of Ishvara, and it will give negative result. When you do what you are not supposed to do, or when you don't do what you are supposed to do, both are problem. When you don't do what you are supposed to do, you will be doing what you are not supposed to do, naturally. So therefore, if dvesha is there, it's a problem. And if you have raga for doing what you are not supposed to do, that is also a problem. Therefore, towards the action or towards the result of action, you have to be objective. Doing what is to be done and accepting whatever comes as prasada. That attitude is important, that is gained through karma yoga, and karma yoga indirectly helps you to get vairagyam. In karma yoga, there is no raga dvesha, only the sense of duty is there. Sense of duty is there, therefore you take up the action whether you like it or not and do it, and the result also, whether it is acceptable or not, whether it is to your liking, to your expectation or not, you accept it gracefully as Ishvara prasada. This attitude is important. And also, to gain Vairagyam, you can pray to Bhagavan. You can pray to Bhagavan to get Vairagyam. Jnana Vairagya Siddhyartham, Annapurne Sarapurne, Shankara Pranavallabhe, Jnana Vairagya Siddhyartham, Dikshandegi Cha Parvati. In fact, we should ask Vairagya, because Vairagya is relative freedom. And to conduct our Vyavahara in this world, we must have relative freedom. Vairagyam is required. Therefore, it is also included as part of the prayer. Therefore, Vairagyam is important. If you have the moksha as your goal, the freedom from the bondage, then Vairagyam is important. When you have commitment for moksha, naturally you will have commitment for Vairagyam. Iccha Ragityam, which is the second important sadhana. Sadhanam. After Viraga, then comes the Shamadhi Shatka Sampattihi. Sampatti means wealth. Sampatti. In fact, these are the real wealth. There are two types of sampatti, wealth. One is external wealth, other one is internal wealth. This Shamadhi Shatka Sampatti. Shatka is sixfold. Sixfold wealth. Beginning with Shama, etc. These are the real wealth, internal wealth or inner wealth. Inner wealth beginning with Shama, etc. What are they? Shamaha, Damaha, Uparamaha, Titiksha, Shraddha, Samadhanam. Shamaha. The word Shama means mastery, mastery over mind, that is called Shamaha. Here, the student asks the question, Shamadhi Shatka Sampatnihi Ka, what are those sixfold wealth, inner wealth? Then the teacher lists out the names, Shamaha, Damaha, Uparama. These are nothing but names. Then the student further asks, what is Shama? Mano Nigraha, that is mastery over the mind. It is called Shamaha. What is Damaha? Mastery over the senses. Nigraha means mastery, not control. Sometimes it is translated as control of the mind. Controlling the mind is like the whipping the mind. Mind should not be whipped. Mind is not for whipping. Mind is an instrument. Mind is an instrument. So we should have gained sufficient mastery to handle it. How to handle the mind? How to handle the sense organs? How to handle the mind? How to... Nigraha is restraining. It is restraining. If you translate the word Nigraha as control, sometimes it gives a sense of whipping the mind. The mind nature has to be understood. The nature of the mind has to be understood, and accordingly, it should be taken over. The more you try to control, the more it will create problem. The more it will create the problem. It is also an instrument. Being the instrument, it does what it's supposed to do. And you are not the mind. You are not the mind. Mind is an instrument. If this understanding is there, then handling the mind will not be the problem. When you strongly identify with your mind and the mind backed up by the mind, the sense organs all will create the problem. Therefore, Nigraha is important. We'll talk about Shama and how to gain Shama and all this in the next class. So we stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
Dhanyavada Guruji.
Dhanyavada Guruji.
Dhanyavada Guruji.